श्री मधुसूदन मिस्त्री जी,
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर। इट इज आफ्टर ए लॉन्ग टाइम दैट आई हैव जस्ट गोन थ्रू द बजट। आई यूज्ड टू डू दिस एक्सरसाइज फॉर द स्टेट बजट एंड फॉर इयर्स आई डिड दैट फॉर यू नो गुजरात स्टेट एंड इन बिटवीन आई जस्ट स्टॉप इट but I again myself try to see to it that budget is read, especially keeping the poor of the people in mind. So figure I am mentioning here is figure mentioned in the budget heads and not the department basis. Say for example the 2049 is a budget head for interest payment. So all the department, the figure mentioned that any department which pay the interest payment has to be accounted in a budget head 2049. So are the other departments, say other budget head like 2202 is a budget head for the general education. So any department which spend money on a general education has to be accounted in a, you know, the budget head of 2202, or for that matter the 2401, which is an account, you know, for the crop, you know, the product. So all this, the budget, the information or the figure I am mentioning is already accounted in all these budget heads, sir. Sir, I just want to draw your attention, not to just criticize you in this sense. What I found in the annual financial statement and profile, expenditure profile, there is a discrepancy in the figures. Figure mentioned in the interest, you know, say for the interest payment, in annual financial statement 2049, the budget estimated 7,28,203.16 crore, while in the interest payment figure mentioned in expenditure profile 2020-2021 is 7,03,203.6. Same is like in a budget head of 2071, which is the pension and retirement benefit. The in a disbursement it mentioned 2,11,681.75 crore, while in expenditure profile the same budget head the figure mentioned is 2,10,680. So I am putting for your record, there are nearly 24 or more the budget head, as well as there are other budget head in a capital head, which you can just correct, or you ask your staff to just correct those figure, and this discrepancy has to go, because it's not, it doesn't look good if the two, I mean in a budget, the documents, if the figures differs, and again I tell you, the figure differs, especially in a budget head, it should not differ. I can understand in a department wise, because department wise the figure doesn't mention you the entire amount spent on that particular activity, is only the budget head. So the second point I wanted to make it, while analyzing the budget in Gujarat, I have always found what is the basis for allocation of the money, you know, by the government. Because at one point I was puzzled, because the Kerala was spending so much of money on education while other states were not. So is it that whatever has come by way of a tax revenue and non-tax revenue has to go in a consolidated fund of India or consolidated fund of the state? When you withdraw that money, when you withdraw it, what is the basis for it? Because in my analysis I found, say for example, that in this budget you have estimated almost 48.1% for a general services. Now general services include interest payment, police and all the other establishment which are engaged in collection of the taxes and others and so on. And very little, it leaves and around 30% you see spent on economic activity, and rest of it goes in social, you know, the social services in the same. What I have found, you know, by and large, that the distribution of money literally create a kind of a society as a whole. The people who are working in a general services or are included in general service, it gives an assured income, you know, to that class of a people, so which then they can, you know, the organize, or as they can plan their future, putting their children to the school, or at least, you know, having a house and so on and so forth. While there is a mass and mass of the people who are in fact, you know, because their income is not assured and they always go around in a search of employment, is creating a different class again. Same is true with the irrigation. Now, wherever the water goes, that class of the farmers that come up, because there is a sure income to them for three seasons, while where the irrigation water doesn't reach, they end up, you know, working as a land, having a land, but work as an agriculture, you know, the laborer as well. So with the disbursement of the money as a whole, we are creating literally a class of people with the public, you know, the money, because you create, we, with public finance, with public money, we build dam, the water goes in certain areas, the, wherever the water goes, their income increases, while others' incomes remain the same. So the disbursements of the money by the government sale, which is, you know, by way of collection from all people of the society, literally create another kind of a you know, the two or three level of the society as a whole. And I think the distribution of financial resources, as well as the you know, the natural resources by way of a policy, literally created the class of the people, you know, the and budget can certainly, you know, the at least minimize the gap. The reason why is because the directive principle of a state policy give a direction, especially to the, you know, the state, as in which says the Article 38-39. In fact, if you look at, you know, it says that the ownership and control of the material resources of the community is so distributed at best to subverse the common goal. Second, that the operation of economic system does not result in the concentration of a wealth and means of production to the common detriment. That there is an equal pay for equal work and both men and women. There are all this. Now the directive principle should be the basis for distribution and deciding, you know, the way that the money should be spent, you know, the answer. Now what has happened? I was just looking at the, you know, the budget statement here, which I have analyzed, you know, with my staff for years that I have been, you know, doing it. That it results, you know, the general services is the 48.31%. Now that includes the interest payment, that is 28.93%. What other one thing I have found always in the deficit, while presenting a, you know, the budget in a March, it's always a tendency by the, you know, the department to show the collection of a taxes through tax revenue and non-tax revenue, you know, on a higher side, and the expenditure on a lower side in the set. That wherever the deficit is there, especially that money has been collected by borrowing. So borrowing always increases. The second trend I have found is the social services allotment always in after the revised budget, it decreases in revised budget from the estimate, and actual budget is actual money spent on that services also, you know, the decreases in comparison with the revised budget as a whole in this sense. On the contrary, if you look at the general, you know, the services, it increases. Actual increase in comparison with the estimate or in comparison with the revised one.
So what happened, Mr. Reddy, now?
Because you,
Mr. Reddy, please conclude.
Sir, one more point, just for give me 2 minutes.
I would like to share my problem. Just 1 minute, Mr. Reddy, please 1 minute. पार्टीज टाइम एलोकेट करके देती है, इट इज़ बेटर टू कोऑर्डिनेट विद द पार्टी, अदरवाइज फिर बीच में आप मुझे कहते हैं, फिर पार्ट टाइम का सारा प्रॉब्लम होता है. हमारे लोग बोलना अधिक चाहते हैं, चेयर तो बैठने को तैयार हैं, हम देर तक बैठने को तैयार नहीं है. ये हाउ वी कैन रन, जस्ट यू थिंक एंड टेल मी, गाइड मी, प्लीज कॉन्क्लूड.
सर, आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू ड्रॉ योर मोर अटेंशन स्पेशली ऑन द एग्रीकल्चर लेबरर. एग्रीकल्चर लेबरर्स आर लैंडलेस. दोज हु हैव अ लैंड, दे गेट water, they get seed, subsidized seed, fertilizer, others and so on and so forth. Those who have a factories and other, they also get bank loan and so on. This is a large mass of agricultural labor, daily wage earner, you know, on the roadside workers and others and so on. Agricultural laborers get 120 days of work according to the Rural Labor Commissions. 100 days work we get it from NREGA. 145 days we left to the mercy of those people wherever they want, and, you know, they go and they try to earn the money. Now that has literally, in fact, put in a, you know, in a poorest condition. So is the daily wage earner. There is no system, and the budget doesn't provide any kind of a solace, you know, to these people. That's one part, sir. And the second thing, last.
Please, point, please conclude now. Already, you have taken 2 minutes more.
Sir, fine. Thank you very much. I think I'd also finish
it. Thank you.